Wu Sangui Rochangbo, 1612-2 October 1678, was a Chinese military general who was instrumental in the fall of the Ming dynasty and the establishment of the Qing dynasty in 1644. Considered by traditional scholars as a traitor to both Ming and ultimately Qing, Wu in 1678 declared himself Emperor of China and ruler of the Great Zhou, but his revolt was eventually quelled by the Kangxi Emperor of the Qing dynasty. Early life and service under Ming. Wu was born in Gaoyu, Jiangsu province to Wu Xiang and Lady Zhu. Under the patronage of his father Wu Xiang and maternal uncle Zhu Daxiao, he quickly rose to the rank of full general at the young age of 27. Wu was one of the generals in 1640 at the Battle of Songjin, in which Qing forces defeated the Ming armies, but he escaped capture. Defection to Qing. On 27 May 1644, Wu opened the gates of the Great Wall of China at Shanhai Pass to let Qing forces into China proper, forming an alliance with the Manchus. Wu ordered his soldiers to wear a white cloth attached to their armor to distinguish them from Li Zicheng's forces. Wu Sangui did not side with the Qing dynasty until after the defensive capability of the Ming dynasty had been greatly weakened and its political apparatus virtually destroyed by the rebel armies of Li Zicheng's Shun dynasty. After capturing the Ming capital Beijing and taking Wu's family there into custody, Li Zicheng sent a message to negotiate Wu's defection. When Wu took too long to reply, however, Li interpreted his lack of response as a refusal to surrender. Li then executed 38 members of the Wu household, including Wu's father, whose head was displayed from the city wall. Enraged, Wu contacted the Qing regent, Dorgan, to negotiate an alliance. Wu agreed to open the gates of Shanhai Pass and surrender to the Qing. Together, Wu's army and the Qing forces fought Li Zicheng at the Battle of Shanhai Pass, defeating the Shun rebels. Having defeated Li's main army, the Qing marched into Beijing unopposed and enthroned the young Shunji Emperor in the Forbidden City. Loyalty and revolt. After he defeated remnant forces consisting of Ming loyalists in southwestern China, he was rewarded with the title of Pingxi Wang with a fief in Yunnan by the Qing imperial court. It had been extremely rare for someone outside of the imperial clan, especially a non-Manchu, to be granted the title of Wang. Those awarded the title who were not members of the imperial clan were called Yixing Wang or known as vassal kings. Wu was not trusted by the Qing imperial court, but he was still able to rule Yunnan with little or no interference. This was because the Manchus, an ethnic minority, needed time after their prolonged conquest to figure out how to impose the rule of a dynasty of a very small minority on the vast Han Chinese society they held in their hands. In fact, as a semi-independent ruler in the distant southwest, he was seen as an asset to the Qing court, and for much of his rule he received massive annual subsidies from the central government. This money, as well as the long period of stability, was spent by Wu in bolstering his army in the southwest, in preparation for an eventual clash with the Qing dynasty. In 1673, the Kangxi Emperor decided to make Wu Sangui and two other princes who had been rewarded with large fiefs in southern and western China move from their lands to resettle in Manchuria. As a result, the three revolted and thus began the eight-year-long civil war known as the Revolt of the Three Feudatories, with Wu Sangui declaring himself the all-supreme military generalissimo. In 1678, he went further and declared himself Emperor of the Great Zhou Dynasty, with the era name of Zhao Wu. He established his capital at Hengzhou. When he died in October 1678, Wu's grandson Wu Shifan took over command of his forces and continued the struggle. The remnants of Wu's armies were defeated soon thereafter in December 1681 and Wu Shifan committed suicide. Wu Sangui's son-in-law was sent to Beijing with Wu Shifan's head. The Kangxi Emperor had Wu Sangui's corpse scattered across the provinces of China. Wu Sangui's son, Wu Yingzhong, married Princess Jianning, the 14th daughter of the Kangxi Emperor's grandfather Hong Taiji. She was Fulin's sister. In popular culture, in contemporary China, Wu has often been regarded as a traitor and opportunist, due to his betrayal of both the Ming and Qing dynasties. However, more sympathetic characterizations are sometimes voiced, and it is clear that Wu's romance with and love for his concubine Chen Yuanyuan remains one of the classic love stories in Chinese history. Wu's early life and military career are portrayed in a more positive light in the CCTV television series The Affair in the Swing Age, in which he is shown to be forced into making the fateful decisions which have made him famous. Wuxia writer Louis Cha's novel The Deer in the Cauldron portrays Wu as a powerful nemesis to the Kangxi Emperor, who sends the protagonist of the novel Wei Xiaobao to scout out Wu's forces in Yunnan. Great Zhou Dynasty.